Hello and welcome everyone, my name is Drewlik and we're doing PvP. Today, I, once again, am on my mercenary, still in the process of kind of finding out about 3.0, and I have to say, kind of getting used to it, you know. It was a bit of a shock, and also as I am doing a nice gesture, I nearly missed the entrance right here. But I do actually find it, and you know, some things are still very bad. Like, look at this. As I'm just bursting away at that sniper, I fully burst him, and he has got very limited cooldowns going. So he popped his orbital shield, and he never actually dropped below 60%. And yeah, they have got two healers, and he just gets full healed all the time. So you know, just switch up targets, kill someone else who's less skilled than that guy. As the Marauder tries to kind of chase me around right here, and I just stun him, and I just think, yep, yeah, that's just you going to die there. Now he went in this right there because he did not want to die actually, and he should appear again. That's the way he is, and I'm completely bursted low right there, but get some nice cooldowns going, so I do survive, which is nice. As I'm kind of trying to burst the healer right here, you know, that's the thing what I was talking about, which is quite infuriating. It's not that infuriating, you know, it's just something I have to live with actually, because you know, if I would actually be infuriated every single time somebody does not die, then I can maybe get myself a pacemaker for 3.0, because basically I would just suffer of being infuriated all the damn time because nobody dies, and this is something you have to grow to accept. And I think he does that. Yeah, he does that. Now that's sweet justice and beauty coming in right there. Now as this guy just kites us back, you know, he just survives because why not? Why not? Why just, you know, everybody lives, you know, that's just, I think that's just the main theme which you could just generally go for. Everybody lives. Now I'm doing some good damage, and I'm not actually getting focused, which is nice. I very much appreciate that, you know, except that one time I got bursted earlier. It is quite nice, so I have to say, you know, not complaining that much. But now I'm doing something which, you know, pre-3.0 was okay, you know, just going out here, just trying to finish him off, does not work out, and I should die if I overcommit any further to this one. Now look at him, he's so low, and he just vanished, lost my thing, and his hots just started ticking. Now I'm getting held up by that guy, just stun him right away, and he's full again, because why not? Why shouldn't you be full? You know, that's just a thing. Finding myself in a very difficult situation, got baited out. That was tunnel vision at its finest. I do not condone this sort of behavior, that was kind of bad. And as I'm kind of, you know, so worked up about this, I just die again because I'm just that dumb. You know, you really have to play with more caution in 3.0, because you're not the king, you're not King Rambo anymore, you can't do anything on your own. This is something I have to grow into, I have to learn it. Because quite frankly, I'm not Superman, you know, I never was Superman, but you know, in a war zone context, you're not Superman anymore, which is kind of bad to get used to, because as I was talking about at the beginning, is that of course, if you would have like two healers and like you focus a guy and he gets completely healed, he wouldn't die, no. But you know, you're in a situation where you've got like three or four very good DPS hammering everything they have, all cooldowns, into one person, and he doesn't even drop below 60% without using any cooldowns. And this is just because the healing is that insane. And that's just something, you know, you really have to put emphasis on. Like, the easiest way to actually kill people is like through trickery. What you have to do is you put on pressure on targets all the time, you know, just die because why not? You have to put pressure onto certain targets or onto the healers themselves, and then you take that pressure suddenly away, they will still heal themselves, or they will still heal that target, and he bursts someone out. And the majority of these healers right now cannot react to that, because they are bad healers, you know, they're just OP because of the patch. And what will then happen is that somebody will randomly drop, and also they will not know where they are. So very often you will see that not somebody that is in the backline gets killed, which is not possible anymore since 3.0, but someone in the front line can get easily killed, because you see, they didn't have the line of sight. That was a very good example right there. he did not have any line of sight to heal him right there, and he was completely in our camp right there, and he just could get killed. As you can see right now, look, it is completely and utterly useless to actually do damage to him, because it's not working. It's not working out. Like, 60%, that's the lowest you will ever get, even if you do, like, an insane combo with another damage dealer, and you really get coordinated. It's not going to be enough. So what you have to do, really, and I guess it's kind of a guide thing, is just to switch up targets constantly and burst different targets at different times. And if you do that, then people actually die. So as you can see, I'm putting a bit of pressure on there to kind of trying to get multi-dotting going and stuff like that. As that goddamn Marauder is onto me again, you know, you can just look at the healing just jumping over from guy to guy right there, and you know, it's just really bad. As I said, that's something I have grown to understand a bit more right now, because you know, it's actually no use in me whining about all of these changes. You know, you just have to play through them, you know, because not much is going to happen. As you see now, I'm just kind of try to AoE dot them. You know, it's not very useful. Like, it's kind of like the Pokemon thing, you know. Like, KJ used multi-dot. It's not very effective. And, you know, you do get insane numbers with multi-dotting, as you can see maybe in the end screen. In the end screen, you have got a Madness Sork and a Madness Assassin, who both multi-dotted the entire game. They actually have higher numbers than I have. But, as I said, you know, it's not very effective. It is effective if you get that in large numbers, but you cannot guarantee that you will have, like, a specific comp, which is, like, 4 dots in every game. Another tip you can actually have, we had a very good success with that, is if you have, like, two very burst... capable of what you call it, some very burst heavy damage dealers, and you kind of get yourself coordinated and familiar with the other player. I did that with my rated damage partner, and we just went into battlegrounds and just completely blew up some people. You know, if you get like a power tech or an assassin or maybe even a marauder, then you can really start to blow people up quite easily, and then people actually die. So we had a nice void star game in which none of the enemies actually survived longer than 5 seconds, which is kind of good concerning this new meta game. And yeah, so you know, there's things you can do. So it's not to worry, not to complain about. There's things you can do against this new healers RP thing. And I guess on other servers it's not that big of a problem, because if you have got decent DPS, then it kind of cancels out the new healing buff, you know. So I guess, like, I don't know. Let me know maybe if how it's on your servers. If it is the same experience as I have right here. If it's familiar to you, or if like, or if you're like maybe from a server where actually players are good and DPS is good and these problems do not even occur, we'll be interested in that. Also, I'm going to play on Torfin once I got the once I get the tiles up on that site, so I can have a look for myself how it is there, because you know they are statistically speaking there are more decent DPS on that server, and more decent players in general, like in an overall game sense. So yeah, you know. So just building up my stacks, just waiting around for that pylon to blow up, and maybe head back to mid and do some more damage, which is hopefully going to be nice. I very much like my new supercharge effects of the mercenary. They're quite nice. If you're not familiar with it, on the innovative ordnance spec, it is that you gain 10% more dot damage, and if an dot effect is present, a specific one, and you make and you actually successfully land a auto hit or like any white hit, then you will get a very 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 intense dot going on somebody, and he will most likely burn down from that dot. Now it ticks very hard. It's about I don't know, 5k in 5 seconds or something like that, which is quite nice for a dot, the dot spec. So again, we just use bubble, because why shouldn't you use bubble? Oh, come on, you know, that's just a lot you get. And again, you know, that guy, I really am tired of his shit, you know. The whole game he was just jumping and jumping and jumping to me, so I just stun him right there. Just disrespect him, because quite frankly, I do not want that marauder jumping around me anyway. That's something I've realized, I have a lot more face aggro than before. And this is most likely not due to like name aggro, like I don't believe I'm recognized or something like that. I just think that because I'm playing a mercenary now instead of a sniper, I'm a lot more likely to get bursted, because you know they can jump to me, they can pull me, they can you know, most generally the view that most people have of a merc is a easy target, and so they generally, you know, just hit me over and over again, which I don't know how to feel about it. You know, on the one hand it's okay because I do manage to survive, on the other hand I'm always getting always getting raped in every game. So now I'm doing something very interesting. He tries to kind of do something, but he will not move, because you know that's just how gay he is. That's just marksman spec for you right there. You can see that's marksmanship gameplay right there, not moving a bit as I'm LOS kiting him around that that pillar right here. Just heal up completely, so his damage was completely nullified. But you know that's just the way you play. So I've dealt around the same damage to him, but I've healed up myself. But you know, he just got healed by his healers, so I guess that's even then, you know. But you know, that's kind of the marksman gameplay, you know. Don't move an inch. If you move an inch, you're not a good marksman player. That's also the reason why I'm not playing that spec. It's just for personal reasons. Let's look at that shit, you know. He's going to survive. I mean, look, 20% is not remotely close to actually dying, and he just ambushed me right there. Fortunately, not with that auto crit. You know, what I mean with auto-crit is an automatic critical hit, and you can have that with laced targets. So, fortunately he did not use that right there, because otherwise that would have been nasty. And this game just ends there. We did do more damage and did more had more kills than them, so that's quite nice. Again, my name is Drewlik, you've been watching Drewlik PvP. Have a good one.